Good morning and welcome everybody to the July edition of our Connected Hydraulics web seminars from the heart of hydraulics here in Lower Main. Today we talk about boosting your maintenance digitally, and my colleague Michael Herlein, he has presented a lot of very exciting and interesting information for you. But before we start, I would like to explain a little bit how this works. So I assume some of the 75 participants we already have may haven't been here before. So this is not of front loading from our side. We want to be interactive with you. So besides from the content that Michael has prepared for you, you will have the chance to give us your feedback during the session, to give us your questions or further annotations. And furthermore, we want to interact with you directly. That is why we have prepared some questions for you. So I would say, let's start with the questions first. Sure. So we have some warm-up questions for you to get a little outside of your daily business and inside of this meeting. So are you a machine user or machine manufacturer or distributor or others? So please give us your feedback, and if others, let us know who you are. And you also could write down from where you are participating today. So this is the Asian Pacific session this morning. So let's see whom we have in the call today. So it looks like we have a lot of partners, yep, but also machine users and manufacturers. So as we said, we are about 80 people in the line. I see about 40 feedbacks. So the others, please be a little more interactive and give us your information. Ah, Australia, South Africa, the UK. It's good to see you all. And a lot of people that I already remember from the last times, Finland, Spain, Italy. It's very nice to have you all in this line. Okay. So, looks like partners and machine users, manufacturers, and some others. Okay, second question, please. What industry sector do you belong to? So, we will have some examples from these industries, and let's see if it fits to your origin. So, automotive is coming up, pulp and paper.
Metallurgy.
And a lot of others. So if it's not on the list, please write us what kind of industry sector you are coming from. If you voted for others, it will be very interesting for us to see. A lot of South Africans here today, I see. That's good. So again, South Africa. But I will wait for a second to see about the other industry sectors. But it looks like it's a quite broad range. It's not a very specific participation. Petrochemical, okay. Chemical and pulp. So the chemical industry is also here today. So good to see that. And the last question for the beginning, especially your role inside the company. Are you coming from the maintenance area or maybe from design or sales or even from the management level? Please give us your vote right now. Some salespeople, a lot of salespeople, maybe from the partner side. Then service maintenance, of course, people from design management level, So Luis from management, all of the above. That's good to see. Okay. So I would say thank you first of all for this feedback, and we will heading now into the section of the content Michael has prepared for us. So Michael, maintenance is a topic we talk about a lot since the last years, but
yeah.
you tell us we are boosting the maintenance with digitalization. So what's the boost?
Yeah, what is the boost, and how do we get the boost? That's the question. And you get the boost with our modular digital solution approach for condition monitoring and predictive analytics, our CytroConnect solutions. Because we all know about our typical key offerings from service, these are spare parts, field service and repair. But Stefan, we are active in other fields, digital solution, that's also one of our key offerings.
But first of all, I would say, let us give us your information. What are you working here?
Yeah, before we start, also very warm welcome from my side. My name is Michael Herlein, and I'm responsible for digital services at Bosch Rexroth.
Good to hear.
So Stefan, we always start development with the customer as the key, because the customer, that's where we develop our solution for. So we looked at the customers, we talked to the customers, and we had a look onto the pain points. Because as we saw, the customers are active in different industries with various applications.
I, as a UX guy, is very happy to hear that.
Yeah. So let's have a look at some typical customer pain points that customers tell us. So a first phrase we get is, we are lacking of hydraulic know-how. You're also doing a lot of webinars on Cytro products, on electro-hydraulic systems. You all know that the systems are getting more and more complex. So it's really hard to get the right personnel for the maintenance. A second point we hear a lot of times is we need to operate 24/7. Of course, not every production site has to operate 24/7, but all of them are not allowed to have any unplanned downtime. So that's a key topic they tell us. Third point I have here on the slides is we are facing the problem of long distances to the applications. Mm. So we have different industries. We're not always talking about plant operations. Mm. If you think about mining or if we think about civil engineering, applications can be really far away. And even if we are in plant operations, we have a huge plant, a central maintenance team, a huge workload for the central maintenance team. So a big problem is also finding the starting point of a fault, finding the point where you do the investigation.
And time is money, right?
Time is money, definitely. We will have that. So a fourth point I listed here is we do not have machine insights. Hmm. If we talk about hydraulics, data transparency is still a key topic. So to get insights into the machine is really still in hydraulics, not the normal way.
I have always this picture of a human.
Yeah.
So if you're a doctor, you also need to get all this information about the body. And I think that's what we also will talk about today a little more.
Definitely, we will talk about that. So even if you have the data, and that's the first point, getting the data out of the machine, you have it, but what are you doing with that? That's the big question. And there comes up, do you have the right know-how for that? Doing some analysis, getting the right recommendations out of the data. So that's also a big problem. Mm-hmm. Fifth point, you already mentioned it, high downtime cost. I think that's clear to all of our participants here. If the production stops, there are high downtime costs due to extra logistics cost, emergency repair, production stop cost, or any penalties that come up from contracts. And a last point, and there are many more, what I highlighted here is we hear from customers, we need a reliable partner. A lot of customers are not just looking for somebody who is supplying them just components, they are really looking for somebody to work together with and to get also know-how from us. And that's exactly what we're aiming with our CytroConnect solutions. On the one hand side, we're offering plain software as the customer if he wants it, but we're also offering the full service and to help him, to give him maintenance recommendations and so on.
Okay, so thanks for this first insight, and I really like it that you start from the customer perspective. Yeah. But I think we have a lot of technicians here or a lot of engineers, so maybe you can summarize a little bit about the basics of condition monitoring.
Yeah. I think that definitely makes sense to go a bit in theory, to also look a bit more at customer requirements we get. And therefore, I brought a small graph here. On the x-axis, you see the time. And on the y-axis, you see the machine condition. So you see the typical behavior of a machine, how a machine is developing. So everything was running fine over a certain period of time. You see that in green. but then there was a decreasing of the behavior until it comes to the failure. So Stefan, this time during the where it was decreasing, maybe it was totally obvious. You heard some additional noise from the pump, the motor, or even there was leakage, and you directly saw it. But maybe what's not obvious at all. So a first system, just to get some insights into the solution and what is going on at the application, is a condition monitoring, a live monitoring of data to get insights, and then also to help you to solve the question, what has happened there? But of course, we want to move steps earlier. And the first thing to move a step earlier is to add rule-based analysis to get deeper insights into the application and to see if a machine is working in defined conditions or if it's working outside defined conditions. So with notifications and warning on the system, and that really helps to get insights and solves the question, what happens? So you really see what is going on. But that has definitely a lot of benefits, but there are also problems. So you have to set up all these rules. There's a lot of effort. You're doing that for each of the signals. You also have to look on each notification you get. This could be a one-time alert. This could happen more often, so that really needs know-how. And also the monitoring needs somebody to do it. But we can also move even one step earlier. So we're in the earliest phase. We're realizing here a predictive approach, a data-based approach. So we're using machine learning algorithms. We're using AI. So we're building up trained and learned modules and then are detecting anomalies, detecting deviations from the running system, and then only look into the data if it really makes sense, if we have to do an analysis, and then realizing a predictive approach and can then solve the question, what will happen in the future?
So it's a quite broad field
where
we could also offer things, and I know we have something to offer. But based on your experience, what are the expectations from the customer perspective? Is this something you can already say? So this brand, this industry is more into that, and this one is this, or?
It really depends on the application and what customer wants to see. We will see that later in some application examples. Some of them are really happy with a small solution just to get some insights, for example, for remote operators.
But we have the chance. We have a lot of participants. So maybe let's ask you. So question to you. Out in the field, what would you expect from a condition monitoring system to boost your maintenance? It's a multiple answer question, I would say.
Yeah, definitely.
So you could have a look at it and give us your feedback, and we'll give you some seconds for this. We have now more than 100 people in the line.
Yeah.
So thanks for being here again. And let's have a look. Live data monitoring looks like to be very relevant. That's maintenance recommendations on anomalies. Web-based interface, that's what I expected. Notifications on exceeded boundaries. So it's still broad, but live data monitoring, I think.
Definitely, but also the other ones are interesting for the customers. That's good to know. That also brings me to my next slide, where I want to talk about, and these are our solutions that we are offering from Bosch Rexroth, our so-called CytroConnect solutions. These are different solutions, three packages, monitor, maintain, and predict, and they are tailored to your customer needs. We saw different expectations for the from the customers, and that's exactly what we're solving with these three packages. So the first one, the monitor solution, is condition monitoring. We're extending this in the second solution, our maintain solution, adding a rule-based analysis, adding our know-how to that solution. So we're coming to a rule-based analysis here with further insights into the data with more information.
But to be sure, you already have from the beginning, from the monitor level, direct entry to the live data.
Definitely. We will go in detail into every solution, but definitely. If you see it, the live monitoring is over the whole applications. And the third solution, like call it the biggest solution, call it the high-end solution.
Generally, the North Star.
The North Star. It's our predict solution. There we really realize a data-based approach based on machine learning, AI, so learned and trained models, and really get deep into the data and also realize a predictive approach. So Stefan has mentioned, this is a really quick overview about the solutions, our solution set. What I want to do together with you and our customers is go into detail, go into each solution, look also at the UI, how it looks, and also look at some customer examples.
That's what I wanted to ask for. We always want to have some real examples also.
Yeah,
but definitely. I know you have some. Okay, let's start.
So let's start with the small solution, the monitor solution. As mentioned, you have sensors connected to a data acquisition unit. We will talk about that later, but we already see it here between us.
Yeah, if you have wondered what this is, you will learn in a second.
Definitely. So you have the sensors connected to the data acquisition unit, sending the data to the cloud. And what you get, as already mentioned, is the live monitoring of the data. But you also have access to the historical data of the last 24 hours. I present also here a screenshot of one of our latest products, the service hydraulic access, the CytroForce, and you directly see some key values like the average tank pressure, the oil temperature, or the motor temperature. But Stefan, let's do not just talk about a screenshot. Let's go live into the solution.
I'm an online guy, so please show us something.
Yeah, let's go into the solution. I will just click on it. No, that was not the right. So I directly opened a live application. So this is an application that is running at the moment.
Where is this located? Just to be curious.
It's a customer location.
Okay.
So I cannot tell the customer name,
okay.
But we are allowed to show this application with no further information. And you directly see some information about the CytroBox. That's the monitor UI of the CytroBox. You see information about the average power usage. You see information about the reservoir temperature, for example.
I'm not sure if you can read that. It's maybe because of transmission, but it's about 5,000 hours in
that's operating,
and its actual temperature level is 50 degrees by 150 bar pressure right now.
Yeah, then you see also the system pressure, as you mentioned, that you see it's changing. Now it's 114, so it's a live application. And we also see the current reservoir level here.
Nice.
But as already mentioned, we can also go into the historical data. So
what
I will do that.
What does historical mean in that context?
In the monitor version, we're talking about 24 hours.
Okay.
But we will also see in the other solutions that we extend that. Mm-hmm. So let's do it. I clicked onto the View Historical Data button. And then you see different graphs that are prepared and that are put to different topics. For example, I look now at the temperature.
Mm-hmm.
And if we want to look at the motor temperature, for example, we just click on the motor temperature. And then the graph will change.
So that's very stable?
That's very stable, but we see, there was a rising in the motor temperature.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, maybe we want to analyze that. So we just mark that time frame, mark it, and then it will directly zoom into the data. It will get bigger. You can also zoom in a bit more. And of course, we can also add on other.
That's exciting. You see, it's about 40 minutes ago.
Yeah.
The temperature started rising.
Yeah. And we can also add, if we see the motor temperature, we can also click what did the reservoir oil temperature do at the same time. And if we want to have it both, we can also put it both together.
Some things happened.
Yeah. Of course, you can zoom out and so on. I think that's clear. But Stefan, you see, we can directly look into the data, see the change of the data, and that's exactly what our customers use it. For example, remote operators. They're using their dashboards, look into the data. We had one customer, they directly see the rising motor temperature and they did some changes on the application. Sometimes really small use cases, but the solution was totally enough for the customer.
Wow. It's really exciting to see this live data from the customer side. I just noticed there's one question. It's about a standard. It's from William Ignacio. Why not the ISO 4406? I think you mentioned some standard relation, or did you get the question? So he's relating to an ISO 4406. Maybe William, you can write more information. Yeah, a little bit more information on your question. Please.
Otherwise, if I cannot solve it directly, I will take it with me and give you information afterwards.
Exactly. So maybe that's the right time to notice. Of course, you will get all the prepared data, so the PowerPoint as a PDF with your registration feedback. So you will get everything and also the links that we are showing today.
Definitely. So let's jump back to our solutions, Stefan.
Mm-hmm.
We started with the first solution. So now let's come to the second solution, the so-called maintain solution. Of course, you have the same benefits as before, live monitoring of the data, the sensors connected to the data acquisition unit. Additionally, now we add our know-how, our rule-based analysis. We set up the rules together with the customers. Mm-hmm. We have a lot of domain know-how of hydraulics, and the customers also have a lot of the application know-how of their applications. So we add that together. And you also get, we talked about the history of the data, we also add a full access of the historical data. So that gives you a lot more insights into the data. but I want to also show one simple example from a customer, how they used it.
Before you do this, I see also here you write down sensors, and we already got a question. I think it's from India, from Manik.
Yeah.
What other parameters you can monitor? So we had the reservoir level, we had the temperature and the pressure, the system and operating pressure.
Yeah.
I think it's relating to the sensor that you're using, right?
Yeah, it depends on the sensor. Actually, every sensor is possible. Or like if it's about flow, particles, even from if we talk about motor, it's about the motor engine.
We have one sensor already.
I also have one sensor here. We will see that later. It's a temperature sensor that we are using. So that really depends. We can also get information out of an existing control. So really, there are a lot of possibilities.
And then the question again from William. Do I have to have hydraulic knowledge to analyze the data? Or Rexroth also supply a simple interface where the customer can easily see the health of the machine?
We're coming
that's
to that
good,
topic.
That's a good ramp.
Who is it? William? Maybe we can wait some more minutes, and then I will talk about that question, definitely.
And then the last question, so I will end up the question section. Can you monitor multiple systems?
Sure, of course. You have a lot, your Cytro boxes, for example, if we talk about that application we saw, then you have for each application the dashboard.
Okay.
And also, if we're not talking always about system solutions, about standardized products, if we talk about an HPU, there's a setup in the UI that you directly see the whole application.
Okay, so let's continue with the maintain package now.
Yeah. We started with the rule-based analysis, and that is also maybe regarding the question, the first start to get an insight if a machine is in a good condition or not, so if it's in defined boundaries or not. So I have one example here. We already know the UI now. That's a bit small, but it's about the detection of a slow system leakage. We see so the tank level here on the y-axis, and we have the time frame on the x-axis. I put it additionally an average oil level that is normal for this application. And you see it's slightly decreasing.
Mm-hmm.
So I made it in a screenshot that is more zoomed in. There we see it more clearly. What we do, we add the rules. So we add one rule on a recommended operation range and a second one on a critical range of the oil level.
Mm-hmm.
So what we directly see, there was a system leakage. It's going below our recommended level. So what does the system do? It automatically sends a message to the customer via mail and says, hey, your oil level is leaving our recommended level. Mm-hmm. So it's not the biggest fault because it's not
just
the critical
notice.
Level. It's a notice. But they know, hey, we now have time. We have time to refill the HPU. As mentioned, you see also in the red line, our critical level. That's exactly what the customer did. He had time. We see that in the green circle. He refilled the HPU, so everything was running fine again. We avoided any damaging operations. The customer was happy, we are happy.
Great.
But we can also solve other use cases with our maintain solutions. If we talk about energy consumption and optimizing the system, and we also saw the UI of the Cytro Force. For the Cytro Force, we also put in our know-how if we think about changing seals. So we already implemented rules about changing the seals when you have to do it after a certain period of time, after the travel distance of the cylinder, because we measure that as well.
Mm-hmm. What are the, somebody asked about the resolution. So what are the time frames? Is it on a 10-second basis, or how often do you collect the data? Or
that
is it
really
open?
Comes up. We have different approaches. For the temperature, it doesn't make sense to do it every millisecond.
Yeah,
there will not be a big change, but we can go up up to 1 millisecond.
Okay, so you can adapt it to each signal.
Yeah, so like we also have high sampling applications. We go up, for example, for the pressure applications. Mm-hmm. If we want to detect any pressure spikes in pumps, that's a typical use case. And therefore, we use also 1 kilohertz measuring.
There's also one question about the software itself. So is there an API possibility to integrate this data view into other softwares? Have you done that already? Or
we are also, for example, if we talk about an OE customer, they have a cloud solution, they have a monitoring system, they are also, we talk about, and we're doing a cloud-to-cloud connection. So sending data to us, doing some analysis and sending it back. So, but that really needs to be discussed. These are really specific applications, mainly from OEs, the OCE section.
Okay, so let's continue, I think, with the most compelling level.
Yeah. We heard about prediction, we heard about health status. Our last solution, our highest solution is the Predict, the Cytro Connect Predict. So what we do here is we're realizing a predictive approach, a database analysis based on machine learning and AI. So within our cloud, algorithms search the received data for anomalies using a machine learning algorithm. So our AI algorithms build up learned and trained models during the learning phase and then search the received data for anomalies, deviations, and what they are doing. They are building up component and system behaviors. So how is the behavior of the system? We will see that in a few minutes in our example. So what the customer then in the end gets, if there is an anomaly, so they get an information from us. They get a maintenance recommendation. What they should do then to better plan his maintenance, to do his timely spare parts management, and so on. Because the predictive analytic parts involves the monitoring as well as the early detection of error patterns, as well as our maintenance recommendations. And what we're doing additionally is we're giving a quarterly report about your applications. We're telling you, oh, this was the performance of the machine. We see that problems. Of course, we tell the problems directly, but we sum it up. We also do some where we say this could be optimized. So really get a report about all the, with also some chart information for the customers.
So a lot of questions coming in, but I would say let's conclude here with the example that you have prepared, and then we will go back to your questions.
As mentioned from the maintained solution, of course, you have the same benefits, the direct notification and warnings. But Stefan, you said it, let's go into the application. Let's go into one example. I took one screenshot out of the UI. Here we are about the detection of an anomaly. That's a molding line. That's a molding line from a customer. And you see on the x-axis the time, and on the y-axis we see the behavior of the component, so the calculated behavior of the system by our system, as well as I added one other sensor point. That's the pressure. That's the pressure of the control pump.
It's nice to see all these pressure drops.
Yeah.
And the behavior, what do you mean by behavior?
That's the behavior the system, the CytroConnect predict system, calculates. So based on learned and trained models. So we're seeing at the beginning, if we look into the graph, and I will highlight that a bit, we're seeing that there's a decreasing of the behavior. So there's something wrong. The system automatically detects an anomaly, a change of the system behavior. And that detects it early. So we already see, and our expert is getting active, if there is an anomaly, looks into the data, and I highlighted it here. We have pressure pikes. So we have pressure pikes bigger than 140 bar to let the customers know this control pump is controlled on 125 bar with a pressure relief valve. Well, this should not happen, and there was the customer did not even notice that topic. So what did our expert do after the anomaly was detected? He gave the customer maintenance recommendations. So he told the customer, do an investigation of the pressure.
Take a look.
Take a look at the pressure relief valve directly. Not take a look at the application, really in detail. Yeah. Take a look at the pressure relief valve and also about the default control pump settings. That was our recommendation we gave to the customer. And we also got feedback from the customer. The customer told us, hey, thanks for the information. We found a loose safety nut at the pressure relief valve. So they secured it again. The machine was then running back to normal conditions. We will see that. They also sent us a picture. They also said, that's a problem. We solved it. We secured it again.
So small issues sometimes have big effects.
And we have several things like that. And sometimes it's the cooling of the system. Really depends where the pain point is. And as I mentioned, we automatically saw the information even before the customer gave it that they secured it. Because if we look at the data again, the behavior is going back to normal conditions. We also did not see the pressure pikes anymore.
So that's truly prediction, I would say. And I think it's relating to a lot of questions that are coming in that I've just seen. So it's not that we are measuring the health. It's a combination of sensor behavior and I would say AI-based calculation.
Yeah.
Is this something, how you would explain this blue line?
Definitely. The system is learning different models of the running application. So we also define good and bad scenarios and then see if there is a deviation from that. And that is also calculated in such a behavior index. And of course, we have, I would say, the best expert for hydraulics in our company. They are then also going deeper into the data. If you don't have such an anomaly detection, such a machine learning and AI approach, you need to analyze any pressure pike, actually. So you need to really go into any fault that comes up. That would be hours, and that would be months.
Okay, so yeah, I think some of the questions have been answered. Thank you, Linus, also for answering the question to William concerning the ISO code. And I think it also was answering the question on the health index.
Yeah.
So it's basically different levels of information that you could get, but it's not that you measure the health with one index, but you, let's say, calculate things together.
We're calculating also a whole index of the system, but also for several components, depending on the application.
And then there's one question, can it trend case drain leakage, filter clogging, particles? I would say that's what we said.
So filter, for example, you have different the difference between before filter, after
depending,
the filter.
Depending on the sensor that you're using and drain flow. Yeah, that's already an answer. Thank you for that. And in parts of South Africa and Africa, there's no Wi-Fi connectivity. I assume this package will not be applicable in this case. What about
depending,
Wi-Fi?
Depending how we do it. The setup can be done different ways. So we can use a mobile router, so we mobile signal. We can use, for example, but also proxy servers. If we are in plant operations, we also have customers. We get the Ethernet connection and do it over a proxy. That's a lot of times also really helpful in the plant operations.
Great for this answer. And when I look to this, I always get remembered to this nice movie, 20 years ago, Minority Report. That's, if you haven't seen that, have a look at it. It's great, it's exactly this. So talking about this, this is the brain.
Sure. Yeah?
Going back to the body, I would say that's the brain, that's the logics behind. But of course, every brain needs a body.
You're absolutely right.
We have something here, and maybe you could tell us a little bit of it about the technical setup.
Sure. I would say it's a part of the body, a really important part of the body. To talk about the technical concept, we have different application machinery equipment. I told you something about the molding line we're monitoring. Could be press applications. We saw people from the press section. Mm-hmm. And there we have hydraulic components. In that picture I'm showing here, we have the hydraulic drive unit, our Citro box. But of course could be other systems. What we're doing, this Citro box you see here on the screen has some sensors pre-configured, has them already on board. But of course many applications, they are running in the plant, or they are running for 30 years, more than 30 years. So they do not have any sensors. What our job is and what we're doing is the engineering, the sensor retrofit. We're doing a planning where to position the sensors, which sensors to use. And therefore I also brought one example. I will quickly show it into the camera. That's a typical sensor we are using. That's a temperature sensor that we are using. Can you see it already? Yeah, that's a typical temperature sensor we're using for our applications in various components. But we have a lot of more, of course, like flow sensors, particle sensors, and so on. As mentioned, we're doing the whole retrofit, we're doing the planning, installation, and so on. And of course, we can also get information out of existing controls. But sensors is one part. You need to gather all set sensors, and therefore you need a data acquisition unit. And that's what is standing between us.
It's just a black box.
It's a black box, so please open it. Open the black box. So now we have the black box open.
A lot of wiring and controls.
This is a standard solution we have from Bosch Rexroth. So this is a solution we can directly retrofit for our customers. There are typical modules, like analog modules, like an industrial PC, all you get together that data. As mentioned, that's a standard solution, but we also have modular solutions that can be integrated in a control cabinet directly by the customer. Really depends what makes sense to the customer. So you said it, that's part of the body. And this part is sending the data to our cloud. You would probably say that's where the magic happens. Mm-hmm. And there, the algorithms are working. Our AI anomaly detection is working there. The behavior index calculation is working there. What you as a customer get, and we talked about the solutions, are the Citro Connect solutions. Our three packages, monitor, maintain, and predict. And what you get, and we heard that as one requirement, is the browser-based user interface to get insights into the data.
By replying the sentence, I noticed that you watched the web seminars before, because I use that phrase a lot. So just a hint, if you're interested in a little bit more information about the Citro box that we mentioned, there's a web seminar already available, and we will show you later on where it is.
Yeah.
So I would say technical setup is set.
Yeah.
So let's continue now.
We talked a lot about the solution, the setup, and we saw we have people, participants from different industries here. I just highlighted some where we are currently active with our Citro Connect solutions. Take one branch at the beginning is metallurgy. High density, of course, of hydraulics there. What we're doing there, for example, is monitoring molding lines, rolling mills, or even blast furnace and other applications. Another industry where we have participants is the automotive industry. I put them next to the press industry. I can also tell you why they have a lot of press applications. So we're monitoring there, for example, die cast press applications. Mm-hmm. We're also doing tire presses for an automotive supplier. And another industry that is getting more and more in touch with us because they have really, really high downtime costs is the recycling industry. There we're doing, for example, garbage shredders, scrap shears, and so on. But there are many more applications. There are many more industries we are active in. And what I want to say is we cannot say it's just that industry.
Yeah.
So it really depends. We have to look at the application.
Sure.
We have to look at the customer pain point, what you want to do, because it does not make sense to realize a solution that does not fit your pain points and does not fit your customer needs. So really, if you're interested, let's look into the applications together where you have problems.
Maybe that's relating to the last question here from Rahul. Is the package applicable for refurbished machine equipment? So I also have to take a look at what it's used already, what kind of sensors are in, but...
Sure, of course. If we can take information out of existing sensors, we definitely want to do it. We do not want to do an additional setup of sensors. So really, I have in my team application guys yeah. that are really deep into the technical topics.
And then there's another question. Is there a monitoring option with data that does not come outside from the customer's company?
So we're talking about a local solution, an edge solution. Currently, we're not offering that solution, but we're thinking about that solution.
Okay.
So currently, it's depending also on our behavior calculations and so on, the machine learning, the AI part, we are realizing that in the cloud. But that's also one topic we have in mind to realize a local solution.
And another maybe final question, because we're almost getting to the end. Can this be used in mining machines such as a shovel? But I think you already answered that. Mining is
we have mining applications there.
Applications
if they are driven by hydraulic, and that's typical in mining, that can be done definitely.
Okay, so I hope we saw all of the questions, and we hope we answered them more or less. So talking about now the setup, talking about the offering and the industries that you're going into, I remember the first pains. And there was one pain, lack of hydraulic know-how, but the most relevant pain, reliable partner.
Yeah.
So we have to talk about the costs.
Definitely we have to. That's always a point.
So maybe you could compare that a little bit. So what will happen without or with using Rexroth as a partner?
Yeah. Let's do that. And I also want to come back to our title, boost your maintenance. Optimizing your maintenance, that's what we're talking about. And Stefan, actually the customer can do it two ways. That's simple. He can do it with a partner, as Stefan already mentioned, or he can do it without a partner, doing it on its own. So if we look at the left side of this slide, if you're doing it and on your own, you have the IT infrastructure cost for the systems you set up, for the maintenance, and so on. You, of course, need some additional people doing that, setting up, doing the installation, or doing building up models, whatever needs to be done. So that needs to be done. Another part is the engineering part. For example, doing a sensor retrofit or working on the models as said. And of course, installation of sensors, implementation of the data acquisition unit, and of course, hardware and software you externally buy or if you're developing it on your own. If you're working together with us and use our Cytro Connect solutions.
Good news is the circle is smaller.
The circle is smaller.
That means less cost.
Less cost and less cost blocks and less effort for the customer. That's a really important part. Of course, you have an upfront payment for the hardware and for the software, as well as installation and implementation. Of course, installation can be done together with the customer, with our Rexroth team, or also with partners. But then you have a regular service fee, and that includes costs from the other circle. You have the maintenance cost, you have the storage cost for the data, you have the development of the models, the engineering, all that is put into a service fee that the customer regularly pays, but does not have any effort and does not have to do any maintenance and so on. That's the benefit.
Okay, so I would say let's have these final questions for the before we go to the finalization of this web seminar. So some issue I think we already talked in the preparation. Could you introduce something about the data security, customers' concern about that?
Yeah, of course, that's a typical topic that comes up. If we get the data, we do not have any remote access. So we have a unidirectional way just sending out the data. this data is encrypted, and it's just sensor data. We're not taking out any other data, so it's encrypted. We have different possibilities how to send out the data using mobile router or, as already mentioned, using a proxy server. So we really have different possibilities. We have high standards there.
Okay, and there's a very detailed question. Are you using Nelson's rules to automatically detect strange behaviors? I'm not sure if you want to give away that information.
To be honest, I cannot go too deep into what exactly algorithms we use. That's the brain, and that's what we do
and
for our customers.
Last answer to Ralph, of course, we share this presentation with your login. We got your email address, and you will get it as a feedback. So you presented everything I would say. I think it's all set. The menu is there on the table.
Yeah.
So let's ask you as a final question right now. So what would be the biggest potential for you for condition monitoring? What do you see? Is this unplanned downtime and cost or timely spare parts procurement? So let's have a look at it. Take some time about the answers and give us your feedback. It's very interesting to see what the people pick now from the menu.
Definitely, definitely. For me, that's really interesting. And I will also give some information on that.
So we still have about 100 people in the line. Looks like we already got, just a quick calculation, 70 people answering. That's nice. Thank you for this quick feedback. Yeah, looks like, of course, downtime and cost.
Downtime and cost. And the second part is better planning or early detection of anomalies.
So it's time and money.
Time and money.
Yeah.
For me, like, an assist, that's what I want to talk about now. And also give some figures to make it a bit more visual. I have brought some figures out of existing applications of our Cytro Connect solutions that we have in the field. If we talk about the anomaly detection, what we could realize was an up to 70% faster anomaly detection at the customer side. Second point, and I think that was in the questionnaire, was the first point, reduced breakdown time. We could reduce it by 40% and also the downtime cost by 40%. So that's a really important point for the customer. Availability is a big topic. We could increase the overall in availability of the system by up to 10%. And one topic is also consequential cost of damages. We could reduce that by 30%.
Which is a lot by 24/7.
Definitely, if we talk about 24/7 operations. But one key figure, if we think about such invests, the return on invest is the key figure.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, I cannot calculate a general return on invest over all applications, but what we realized are return on invest less than 1 year, depending, of course, on the downtime cost and the downtimes we could save.
So maybe we should go back to the start.
Yeah.
So we had the pains.
Definitely. My last sentence to that, what I want to say is, we are moving, and that's the boost, from unplanned breakdown to a scheduled maintenance. And Stefan, you mentioned it. We started with the pain points at the beginning. We looked at the customer. I also brought them here again, the 6 points. And there are more. There are definitely more. And we saw we see it at the moment, the question mark at the customer side. What we do and what we think is our solution set, our modular solution set for condition monitoring and predictive analytics, our Cytro Connect solutions with the three packages directly fit to solve these use cases, get insights, save downtime costs, be a partner, and so on.
I would say this is answered. This question mark is really answered. Thanks for this presentation. And as I said, we will get you the presentation, but there's something online also. So maybe
you can
show, I think there's a slide.
Yeah.
You see that there is some information on the web. There's a lot of more information on our websites overall, and definitely also the sales partners or the sales units of Bosch Rexroth, so they have some detailed information for you once you get into detail with them. And what I really like, that you present yourself with your social media profile and people get back to you, because you're a young service guy and you will be available as much as possible. So
definitely, if there are any questions, you already put some questions into the chat, put them in or contact me afterwards. No problem.
And as we're running out of time, just to mention shortly, we don't need to show that. Go to our website. There's this area of the knowledge, and you will find all the web seminars that we have done, including the Cytro box, or go to YouTube on the Rexroth channel. So that's basically the possibility to see or review what we have done here, including our session today.
Definitely.
That will be available in some days. Thank you already for being here. I would like to give you the chance to give us some more feedback on the session. So please fill out these feedback questions, and I really want to say thank you for being here, for taking the time to have a closer look to the boosting the maintenance digitally. And again, thank you, Michael.
Yeah, also thank you from my side. Thanks for participating. And if there are any questions, feel free to contact me anytime.
Okay, stay safe.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.